gonna throw a big log in the sawmill. It's frozen down. I should be able to break it loose with the tractor. Get the key out of the barn. Get the tractor warmed up. And we'll see how this goes. Head down to the sawmill. Put the back stops up. It's gonna be kind of slippery. It's all snow. A little bit of a hill. But we'll get it on there. Sawmill. We'll blow everything off and put it away for the week. But the days are getting a little longer. Might be able to do some sawmilling after work. That's the log I'm going for right there. Nice big red oak. Get it on the sawmill, grab my tape measure, we'll measure it up. Thing's 2 foot round, 10 foot long, and it's pretty straight. Let's get it on the deck. Locked in so it don't roll off. There we go. Alright, nice heavy log. I think I'll bring the level back out and check the sawmill for level before I start cutting this. This big red oak. Today I'm gonna saw up that big red oak. I put on the sawmill earlier in the week. So I'm gonna try and do something a little different today. Go over the sawmill, things I like about it. Had a guy ask me in the comments what I liked about my Woodland Mills, if I liked it. And I told him it was a great sawmill, if you like a workout, which it is, it's a workout. This lumber's heavy, but I got the tractor to help out, so. Let's get into this log. First thing I gotta do after uncovering it is tension the blade, so I don't forget. There we go. It's like 23 inches in diameter. It's 10 feet long. I think I'm gonna get my chainsaw and cut the end. This is the second cut. This isn't The other log I cut was probably the base of this one. So this one shouldn't have metal in it. I think I'm just gonna risk it. 10 foot long. Yeah. Let's see how it goes. All right, I had a video on this in the past, but I'm gonna go over it again. I like to level the sawmill when there's weight on it. And I've had a couple of frost cycles. Ground's pretty frozen right now, but I like to double check, especially when I got a good log on there. I start at this point here because this is where I'm closest to the ground. I got that jack all the way up. And then I level off of that. I go down this side, a little high in the middle, a little low in the middle rather. Go that easy, go right around. Nice and level. End of February. The hawk. Up there in that tree. Ground's gonna start getting real soft, so I should probably get some logs lined up over here. I can just roll onto the sawmill. I'm gonna cut this log, this red oak, up into 4/4. Flat stock. Dry it in the car pull-off for now, and then maybe I'll get a solar kiln project going. I can dry some lumber a little bit faster. I put it upstairs in the barn, but it's a lot of work carrying it up there. Be nice to just have someplace on the ground. All right, got the sawmill nice and level, and I got a used blade on there from last week. I'm gonna see if I can get this thing squared up with that blade, then put another resharpened blade on there to finish sawmilling up the cant. All right, we'll fire up the sawmill. See what this thing looks like on the inside. What I'm looking at on the sawmill when I'm making those cuts and how I determine the thickness. So I have it here. This side's the 4/4 side. See the scale right there? 1 inch on the left, 4/4 on the right. See how they're different? That's the thickness of the blade. Tallied up, for rough sawing lumber. And what I do is right now, because I only got the first cut going, it's set at just under 17 and a half, so I'll crank this thing down so it's just under 16 and a half. That will give me a 4/4 board. Once I flip it over, I'll keep this indicator right on one of these numbers, so every time I crank it, I'll go to the next one and get my 4/4 to keep all the boards consistent. So what I like to do, when I first put the log on there, take a couple of cuts off until I get the width that I want for my cant, and then I'll flip it over. So it looks like, because this one's a little bit punky in the sapwood, it's been sitting on that log pile for a while, I'm going to take another one off, one more cut, and then I'll flip it over. And take some off the other side, so those two cuts are parallel. It looks pretty nice inside. I do have a wormhole right here. That's not a big deal. I'm gonna do something I haven't done yet. I'm gonna go get a bucket of water, throw it on this log, so you guys can see what this stuff looks like, nice and shiny. Be right back. Nice looking stuff. Big board. Oh, this side looks amazing. I gotta wipe that off and show you. Nice big board. I'm at the point now where I want to roll it over. Drop the blade down so it's almost touching, and then I watch it go over the log, and that'll let you know if your board's waving. Nice cut. So I got good wood over here, 16 inches, not including the sapwood. If I go where I get 16 inches off the other side, right there, it's gonna give me like a 14 inch wide board. So I'll end up with like a 16 by 14 cant and I'll slice boards from there. Big boards. All right, I'm gonna get my tractor up in here, put the forks underneath, and roll this thing over onto the forks and place it back on the mill. I ain't messing around with the PV. Here, so I'll make this cut and then probably another one, and that will give me the width of my boards. Then I'll flip it, cut the sapwood off this side, flip that to the bottom, get the sapwood off that side, and then just start cutting my boards. That's when I'll get onto the scale, the 4/4 scale, and start cutting from that. I make my first cut right there. I think I can get underneath that punky sapwood, and at least I'll have a board to make some stickers. I can get it from underneath now. Right here. Changing the blade on this sawmill is real easy. Basically, all you gotta do is detension the blade right here. And these three latches. Open it up. Grab the top. Right here, pull that down first, because if you pull the bottom out first, the blade tips up and gets caught in the top of your sawmill, and you gotta fight with it. I don't think I had this thing on there that long. It was a reshopping, but I think it was the last reshopping I could get out of this one. Let me go grab another blade, put it on there, see if it cuts this oak any better. All right, I got a reshopping blade out of the garage. Throw this thing on there, see how she cuts. Is that a scratch? That's a scratch. Thought that was a crack. Slide it right on there. Alright. Retension the blade.
I get it about 3/4 tight. I'm running around. See how she's tracking. Tracking really good. Got quite a few resharpenings on these blades. I want to say at least 3. So I don't know how much I can get out of them after that. That made a huge difference. I'm gonna show you this one. I like red oak. Beautiful wood. Beautiful wood. Right there, a little spalted on the end, but not too bad. I'm glad I didn't cut it. That's why I was questioning cutting the end off, because it looked kind of punky. But as you can see, it got better. Nice, very nice, nice and heavy. Hello. How we doing? Good. I'm gonna put those back stops up a little bit, and then I think I'm just gonna pick this up with the tractor. I'm not even gonna mess around with the PV. Should roll over good right there. Ugh. Tracker back in here, roll it onto the forks, flip it over, finish this thing up. Heavy log. I left the forks up a little high, so when the thing came down, the tractor was like absorption. It didn't slam down onto the deck. And now with my PV, I think what I'm gonna do is I'll just lower the forks down a little bit and then flip this over with the PV. Slippery. Wow, that thing is heavy. That's crazy. This big, trying to saw this thing up without a tractor, just rolling it with a PV would be pretty difficult and dangerous. Just live slide, live edge it the whole way would probably be the safest bet. It's just it rolling over and slamming down on the mill probably isn't a good thing. 16, just 16. Got some sapwood there, so I'm gonna take one off at 17. Let's see where we go. Let's see what we're looking at. Shooting for 17. Let's see where that puts us on the four-quarter scale. 17 puts us at 14 boards. This top board probably be good for stickers. You know, sapwood. Not very good lumber for building anything. I get some good wood down here. Down there probably be yuck. Yucky. Alright, we'll saw right there. I got 14 boards out of this thing. chilly out. Can't see. A good shot. This camera's definitely not picking up the ray fleck. Guess you're gonna have to take, you see it in this one a little bit. It is beautiful.
last board. I got quite a few sticks of lumber out of this thing. Not too bad. I'll get that up into the carport. When I'm drying all the lumber, I'll probably sticker it all tomorrow. Right now I'm gonna clean off the sawmill. It's a mess. And then take that blade off.